In many ways, Airtable and SmartSuite are very similar softwares. If you find yourself comparing the two tools, this video is absolutely for you, because here I'm going to be breaking down from the perspective of Airtable why it dominates SmartSuite with 5 key features. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, where we help you to organize and automate with no-code tools. As I mentioned in this video, we're going to be taking the perspective of how Airtable is dominant to SmartSuite using the 5 key features that I think are the most valuable things that Airtable offers that SmartSuite does not. Now, before we get into it, a couple of things. Housekeeping, first and foremost, please understand that this video is from a slanted perspective of Airtable dominance. In reality, I love both Airtable and SmartSuite, and to that point, we have actually already done a video talking about the 5 ways that SmartSuite dominates Airtable. So go ahead and check that out for the reciprocal comparison video here. But as I mentioned, this video is taking a very specific approach, and I'm really highlighting those things that Airtable gets right. That being said, I also want to invite you to join me for some free training. If, as you watch this video, you decide Airtable is definitely the software for you, well then please check out my free Airtable training so that you can learn the fundamental building blocks of Airtable. It's deceptively simple looking as a software, but this free training is going to help you understand all those key features so that you can get the most out of the product. You can grab that training at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. I will include links wherever you found this video. All right, now all that housekeeping out of the way, let's jump into the 5 reasons that Airtable crushes SmartSuite when it comes to a head-to-head comparison. And the first one, the biggest one, is interfaces. Interfaces is an element of Airtable that allows you to share your database with other people, with other users, in a way that gives you full control over CRUD. Now, if you're not familiar with CRUD, if you're kind of new to relational databases, CRUD, C-R-U-D, stands for create, read, update, and delete. And these are the elements or the operations that we need any user to have access to. So when we're interacting with data in a relational database, we want to empower our other users to create new stuff, to read existing data, to update data and edit it throughout the process, and in some cases, even delete or remove data from our set. So this acronym CRUD is obviously very important to remember whenever we're sharing our databases. Now, in Airtable, as I mentioned, they have this entire component called interfaces. So after you've already built the backend database and all the automations that are going to empower your workflow, you have to always consider the final component of any project, which is sharing the data. How are people going to interact with this stuff? Interfaces is how Airtable solves that problem, and SmartSuite does not have anything similar to interfaces in its toolbox. Interfaces, as you see here on my screen, this is an Airtable interface that we use internally at our company. And this is our content publication by date. So here I'm looking at a calendar, but if I'm looking at the underlying data that's under the hood of this interface, you'll see it's quite a lot. Check this out. I mean, there's so much data, and it's honestly a little mind-boggling to try to make somebody look at rows and columns like this. When we're working through a particular process or workflow, we don't need to see all the data at that moment in time. An interface like this allows us to break down and only see those elements that we need at any moment. So here I am. If I wanted to look at the piece of content that we published back in December on the 18th about syncing Airtable with Google Calendar, cool. Open up the record and it's right here. Now I want to highlight that I have full control over everything that's being shown here. So not all of the elements that I shared on my database are available here. It's just the high-level stuff that I care about when I'm at this particular stage in the publication process. I need to know what the video title is. I need to know what software we're talking about in the video. I need to know when it's scheduled, and I need to know what stage it's in. I have all the other components. I can go to the files for this video. I can mark this ready for review. I can go to the publication interface and go along in the process. There are many actions I can take from here, but the point is I have the ability to limit what people see for a specific moment in time when they access the interface. And that's exactly what we've done here. Every one of these components in an interface can be edited. So if I were to break down in here, you'll see that here are the elements that I've added to my interface, but all of these other fields are not showing up because they are not relevant for this part of the process. Now, in addition to that, each one of these elements has the ability of being either view only or editable. So I can choose if people can see this, if they can edit it, or ultimately, if it's hidden from view entirely. So this enables me to take full control of CRUD permissions, and when I share my interface, I can make sure that I'm only sharing access to that specific interface at that moment in time. Right here, I can go in, share access to the interface, and choose what level of permissions people have, if they can only read stuff, or if they have the capability to edit the fields that I've marked as editable. So in this way, I am able to share all the information that's happening and being tracked inside my solution, but only share the stuff that's relevant to various team members. And this is a huge slam dunk for Airtable. And as I said, SmartSuite does not have anything like it in its toolset. Now, the second feature that Airtable has that SmartSuite does not is scripting. Now, I've heard some rumors that you can have some access granted inside of SmartSuite scripting, but it's not out of the box. And scripting, while it's definitely a little intimidating, it's sometimes very necessary inside of any kind of workflow that you might build in a relational database. So here I am inside of Airtable Automations, and I can come in and add a script component. So this allows me then to write a little bit of JavaScript and empower my automation to do something that Airtable doesn't natively support. So a lot of the stuff that we see in no-code or low-code solutions is just point and click. You'll notice, by the way, the rest of this automation does not use any scripting. So under certain conditions, in this example, I'm sending a Slack message and then I'm updating the stage of a record. None of that required scripting. But if I wanted to do something more complicated, something that was not available natively inside of the automation tool, well, sometimes I need to go off script. And in this case, I have that scripting element that will empower me to do that. So here's where I can go in and, you know, create webhooks and API calls and all kinds of things that I need to do that are more advanced, not natively available inside of Airtable. This scripting component is a home run. Now you might think to yourself, I'm using no code tools for the very reason that you're just describing, Gareth. I don't want to do scripting. I don't want to do this stuff. In that case, you can always ask ChatGPT for a little bit of help. So there are so many ways that you might want to come up with a scripting workaround. Ultimately, that's just not supported if you don't have a component like this in play. That takes us right to the third reason that I love Airtable over SmartSuite, and it really comes down to the maturity of the product. You know, SmartSuite's only been around for less than 2 years already as of this recording, and Airtable is pushing 10, maybe even more, years on the market. Now, the maturity of product really boils down to two kind of sub-points here. Number one, because it's been around longer, Airtable has fewer bugs. All of those little things that were buggy in Airtable maybe 5 or 6 years ago have been worked out by now. So yeah, there were moments in time, you know, 5 years ago where I might need to refresh my screen or a formula didn't work right or an automation would break. Those things have mostly been overcome at this point. So very rarely does Airtable suffer any bugs. And unfortunately, that's not exactly true for SmartSuite. Now, SmartSuite has come a very long way in the short amount of time that it's been to market, but it still does experience bugs from time to time. And so if you are not wanting to see any downtime, if you want your software to work flawlessly all the time, you might need to readjust your expectations if you're working with SmartSuite, because it's not 100% of the time always going to do exactly what you would expect. Sometimes it does get a little buggy. Airtable, by contrast, does not suffer that problem. Now, the other thing about maturity of product that we should consider is that that is given the opportunity to other tools to integrate with Airtable. So because Airtable's been around longer and it has just a wider net and a greater market share, well, then ultimately more tools are attracted to Airtable and they've integrated with it. So there's a really good chance that there might be a very specific third-party tool that you need for your solution, your needs, and it might not integrate with SmartSuite only because SmartSuite is still so new. But Airtable probably integrates with that because Airtable's been around so long, and so therefore all of these third-party opportunities have already built that integration and that connection with Airtable. This takes me to the fourth key feature that Airtable offers that beats SmartSuite, and that has to do with advanced automation options. Now, this can be a little bit of a touchy one because there are third-party automation tools that you might use for any kind of advanced no-code build that you're putting together. I'm thinking of tools like Zapier and Make that we've covered extensively on this channel. And so for any advanced automation needs, you might go outside to that third-party environment. But there are many, many times when an organization wants to keep things streamlined. And in an effort to accomplish that goal, they don't want to have 5-10 different software all reliant upon this no-code solution. And so it's preferable if you can keep all of your automations natively in your database tool. And so, flipping into Airtable's automation tool here, you'll notice that we have this advanced logic or action option. So when we are adding these automation actions, we can do two things that are not available inside of SmartSuite's automations. The first one is conditional logic. Building some sort of conditional pathing or automations that are dependent upon specific conditions, this is really a cornerstone of no-code automation. Many times you want an automation to perform, but then if condition A is met, you might take a specific action, whereas if condition B is met, you might do something similar but a little bit differently. And that is the whole point of conditional logic and this feature inside of Airtable's automation. So you can run different actions based on the conditions of whatever's happening inside of your automated process. Unfortunately, SmartSuite does not offer conditional actions inside of their automations, so this is a big differentiator for Airtable. Now, the second automation feature that Airtable offers that SmartSuite does not have is the repeating group. Now, this allows you to find a list of things and then perform a series of actions to those items that you found in a list. Let's say, for example, you said, I know that 10 different contacts are connected to the account for Acme. Well, in this example, you might run an automation that says, if I select an account, I want you to find all of the contacts that are linked to them and then perform some series of things. You might need to send an email, you might need to update the status of that contact, etc. Well, inside of SmartSuite, we do have the ability to perform a single action against a list that we found. But we cannot do as Airtable has done for us, build up this repeating group where we have these series of actions and they can be inside Airtable or external to the software. We can do things with email, things with Slack, things with Twilio. There are so many different tools that we can include inside of the repeating group automation, and that automation inside of that group will recur for every single item that we find on that list. This is something that we need a lot of in our no-code automations, and SmartSuite does not offer it. Now, my fifth point that I really want to highlight, this is an amazing, not so much a feature in Airtable, but it's, in my opinion, a way that it is superior to SmartSuite, and that is simplicity. Now, that does not mean that you can't do as much. In fact, I think you can do more when you have simple building blocks. Imagine if you were building something out of Lego bricks, for example, or any other kind of block. Well, if you had a million different types of pieces that you could use, it might be more difficult for you to build the end structure you're looking for. Whereas if you have a finite number of types of pieces, then maybe it's a little bit easier for you to envision what you need to create. Now, let me put this into real examples for us. Imagine that you have tasks. And then inside of your tasks, you have subtasks. So these subtasks relate back to your task. And then inside of your subtasks, you have a similar relationship where they could relate down to sub-subtasks. Well, this kind of thing could happen indefinitely. And as we imagine it in a database, we would build a table for each new layer of sub-subtasks. And it would link back up to the previous layer in the database. Well, you could build that in both Airtable and SmartSuite. But SmartSuite has additional types of fields that you might use. You could actually build subtasks inside of the record inside of your sub-subtask field. And before you know it, you've built this very complicated structure. And when it comes time to automating, because you didn't use the right sized bricks to begin with, it might make your automations way more complicated. So this is kind of a touchy one because in some ways you might say, hey, SmartSuite has all these extra bells and whistles. Isn't that a better thing? But I would argue, as somebody who builds databases on a consistent, regular basis, that it makes things more complicated when you have all these flowery additional features that are not critical to the core structure of building in a database. These are nice to have features, but they're really window dressing. And what ultimately winds up happening when people start using those features is they don't build the proper data schema to support their needs. And that, my friend, means that you end up with a solution that is less than optimally built. If it doesn't scale with you over time, what's the point in building it in the first place? And so for those folks who are newer to building databases, when they get into SmartSuite and they see these additional features like sub-sub-tasks, I fear that it actually complicates the building structure because it makes you feel that you have more control over the thing you can build, but in actuality, you wind up building something that really doesn't scale or offer the real true data schema that I would want to see in a typical database build out. So in this way, the simplicity of Airtable as compared to SmartSuite actually is a pro in my opinion, because it forces you to build things the right way from the beginning, and that allows you to build a solution that scales. Hey, I know we went pretty fast in this video, and maybe you found some of these points to be controversial, so let me know if I missed anything or what your opinions are in the chat below. And in the meantime, my friend, keep on building.